So are we live yet? So we are, I think, the second game week, second game of the second game week of the Indian Super League. Today we have we are live. I think we are live. Yeah. So we are live today, and today we have Kerala Blasters versus North East United, which is going to be a cracker, which is going on, and it's a cracker of a game because after a very dry first week, it has been much more, you know, exuberant in terms of goals that we are seeing this week. In terms of like people who have scored. Yesterday's game was a little, you know, like not that entertaining in the sense. It is much more dry compared to the other weeks. But yeah, nonetheless, all in all, it has been a much more, you know, like high scoring week. And, you know, like, I don't know, the high scoring week, at least for the fans, it is much, much more interesting. But in terms of coaches, it is not very good, because then if the scores are very high, that means there has been a lot of mistakes from both the side. I don't know, some one coach in the past said, some famous coach, European coach, that a perfect game of football would end in a nil-nil. I don't know whether you get it, but yeah, if no one makes mistake, then there are going to be no goals in the game. So yeah, so this week, in the today's games, Kerala Blasters are leading by 2-1 against North East United. It's live from GMC Stadium, Bambolim. So Sergio Sidoncha, the Spaniard, opened the scoring in the 5th minute before Gary Hopper opened his scorecard for this season's ISL when he converted the penalty, which was dubious to say the least. You know, like, it was like not a very good it was not a very clear out and out foul. At least that was what the general consent was. So he converted the penalty, and Kerala Blasters were leading by 2 when they went into the halftime before Kwesi Appiah, who pulled one back for North East United in the 51st minute. You know, like, he also scored in the previous game when his solitary goal gave them the lead and the win against against Mumbai City. And Kwesi has been he has been kind of carrying, at least in terms of goals for North East. They have scored 2 in 2, and he has been the person who has scored both the goals. But unfortunately, he also missed a penalty shortly after he converted the goal. In the 66th minute, he missed a penalty, which would have pulled the game back, and it would have been so much more exciting, you know, like going into the final slot or the final quarter of the game. So now 87 minutes have passed, and in terms of statistics, Kerala Blasters have had 6 shots in comparison to North East United's 12. Kerala Blasters have 2 shots on target, whereas North East have 3. Possession has been quite equal in the sense that Kerala and North East have around, you know, like around, in and around the 50 mark, 50% mark. Okay, Sushil. Yes, Sushil, how are you? I'm good. Welcome back. Thank you so much, Sushil. You also are welcome, because you are the only person who comes to see. And there's some other people also, but yeah. So, yeah. So, in terms of attacking output. Okay, my camera has gone off, but nonetheless, I will continue. Okay. I think I'm back. Yeah. So, in terms of corners, North East United boast by a very huge margin. They have 7 corners in comparison to Kerala Blasters 1, but nonetheless they have not been able to convert anything out of the corners, and it has been a fairly aggressive game in terms that both of them have a lot of fouls. North East United boast 16 fouls in comparison to Kerala's 15. So we enter the final. Oh, that was a very, very close chance for North East United, and they could have equalized the game. So, yeah, so in terms of lineups, the major shocking point for the exclusion of Sahal. I really personally don't know what is the reason behind it, but nonetheless, he's not in the squad altogether, not even in the bench. But it has worked for them, and they started with a 4-1-4-1 formation with Gary Hooper leading the line. And for North East started with a 4-3-3 formation, quite similar to what they played last week. And they had Rakesh Pradhan, who was very close to coming to the show, but due to the commitments of ISL, he has not been able to come. So him, Apia and Mite lead the line, whereas Kamara, who has been instrumental, you know, like one of the instrumental people in the previous game, at least, and I think he was the hero of the game. He, Gallego and Laleng Mawia are in the center of the park, forming the three-man midfield. And you have the reliable Fox and Lambert in the center of the defense, with Mehta and Kumar in the sides. So, yeah. Okay, so it's a draw, and it's a 2-2 for Sila. Has just scored the goal. He just came on and he has equalized for North East United. It's in the 89th minute, 30 seconds. So it's an amazing time. This has to be one of the most exciting games, you know. Like, although I don't think you can see the excitement through my face here, but yeah, I mean, like, Gerard Nuss would be extremely happy, you know, with the scoreline, and the substitution clearly worked what he wanted, and he would have picked it up from someone like Rafa on his way, you know. Like, he has been the under a lot of people. He has been, you know, like the apprentice under a lot of people. So it was an amazing control and a left foot volley into the top left corner. Lovely chest down, and the center back Kone could not do anything, and even the goalkeeper left just gasping and watching the goal. And yeah, so it's a 2-2 as of now. So North East United have equalized, and they probably will go on to draw the game. So what does that have in store for the league table? So North East United have come back from 2 goals. Do not forget that. So they have North East United. They draw this game, they go up to the top of the summit with 4 points after 2 games played. 1-1, drawn 1, goals 4-3, and goals against 2. Kerala Blasters will be in a more difficult position because they have played 2 and they have 1 point similar to Goa. You know, like, who, they almost have the same statistics. I think they have the same statistics. They have played 2, lost 1, drawn 1, goals 4-2, goals against 3. I mean, it's exactly the same. And yeah, it's quite a good fight back from North East. And probably this week has been more, you know, like, gold-fiesty. And I think till now, only one Indian has scored. I think Anirudh Thapa is the only Indian to score a goal in the ISL in this season. So that's quite detrimental to the idea of ISL. But nonetheless, I think that it improves the game. You know, like, when I was seeing Nepal's game, you know, like, I was seeing the last year's qualifiers against Australia, it is poor. It is poor, to say the least. Like, I don't want to, like, make it an adult or a U18 or I don't want to, like, make it, you know, like, adult content or not children friendly by using words which probably a lot of kids would be scarred to hear. But you know, like, Nepal's game, when you watch that game and when you see, like, how they're not good, dude. They're just seriously not good enough. And when you see, like, the quality, the passing, the position, the change in tactics that is being used in ISL, you realize, like, the ISL has done a lot good for the game in terms of, like in terms of the experience that the players get in while playing for a lot more different coaches with different ideologies. You know, like, you have someone like, today you have two coaches. You have Kibu Vikuna, who is the coach of Kerala Blasters, and you have Gerard Nuss. Kibu has been all over the world almost, and he in Poland and a lot of places. Last year he won the I-League with Mohun Bagan, the now ATK Mohun Bagan. Like, now there's no club called Mohun Bagan, there's the ATK Mohun Bagan. ATK is also not there, it's a merger. So now with Mohun Bagan, with the original Mohun Bagan, he won the I league title last year, and that added a lot of weight to his coaching pedigree. And in terms of Gerard Moose, he has been an apprentice to a lot of good people, to name a few. Rafa Benitez at Liverpool, and he has also been at Brighton. I think he has been with, under Avram Grant, and Avram Grant was former, I think, Northeast United manager. So I mean, like, they bring a lot of ideology into the teams and to the players they're coaching. And in terms of hero of the match, I think Dylan Fox has received the hero of the match, and there is a 5 minute added time, and Northeast United look to have got some adrenaline push by the goal, and I don't know whether they'll be able to snatch the winner here. But Silla, definitely the equalizer, the person who scored the equalizer, is in top, in a very jovial mood. And Gerard Nuss would want a win, of course, because that would then stamp authority, or it would be a signal of intent, you know, like that they are not here to just play and be around and. Be around, and they are here to win. And Northeast United generally have not performed well in ISL as a whole, you know. And I'll just let this finish, and then we'll go to UCL. UCL has been more colorful, to say the least, you know, like yesterday, what we spoke about and what has happened. I mean, like, it's not bad, but it has been more colorful. Like, if the, like, in terms of, I'll say, like, the person who equalized for Northeast United is Idrissa Sia. He has played for the likes of Queen's Park Rangers. You know, like, he played 61 times. He played for Anderlecht. He played for Zulten YGM in Belgium. So, you know, like, and Bastia in France, Le Mans, like, amazing. Like, you know, those are like big teams, big, big teams, in at least in terms of European market. And that he will bring his own, you know, like, experience and what he gets to the table, and probably youngsters or even someone like Rakesh, who is pretty young in comparison to the players available. And the game ends in a 2-2 draw. Like, Rakesh is 23 years old, you know, and he's just beginning his career, and he would learn a lot from someone like Idrissa Sia, because he can pick up some, you know, like, maybe he'll not change as a player, but some experiences, like what he scored right now, maybe Rakesh would be more nervous if he would have gotten a chance, or maybe he would have scored even a bigger belter. But, you know, like, some normal, like, to keep calm and score would probably be something that he will bring to the table. And yeah, so the match has ended full time. The scoreline is 2-2, and Kerala Blasters will be not satisfied, to say the least, because they were winning by 2 goals, you know, like, at half time, and they have blown it up. Okay, Sushil has asked, what do you think the cause for being Nepalese football too much poor? Okay, Sushil, if possible, I'll show you one clip. Okay, let me just show you a clip, okay? You say me, I'll not show you the clip. It's bad to, you know, like, mouth it like that. But I'll send it to you, probably. I'll send you the clip. I'll not show you. I'll not play. Okay, should I play it here? Okay, I'll play it here. Just 1 second, just give me a problem. It's a very short clip, okay? It's a 24-second clip, and I can get probably a copyright issue. I'm not sure. Okay. I don't know whether you can see. Can you see? Sushil, if you can see, just let me know. Can you see? Okay. Okay. Hopefully. Okay. So basically, yeah, I think you can see. So let it come. Yeah. Okay. I think you can see. So yeah. So this is the screen, and I'll just play it. You see the game here. Okay. I'll be pausing and playing, because or else I'll get a copyright strike. You see the game here. Australia leading 4-0. And they were leading in the first half itself, like, you know, by 3-0, and they missed a lot of chances, and they were just playing, toying around. And this was like last year in the World Cup qualifier. You see that players here. You see this person here. I don't know whether you can see. Like with the, I'll just try unnote it. Okay. So if you see this person here, I don't know whether you can see him or not. I just made a drawing there. He is Ryan Grant. Okay. So basically, he is the fullback. And you see his position there. Okay, you see his position. Where is he? And similarly, that is not the only case. So I'll just see. Yeah. Okay, so you can see the drawing. Clear. Okay, so we'll move on and we'll see what is happening here. And let me see. Okay. So I'll just clear all drawings. You see how they are toying around, okay? They're like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 people. And he's like, so you see him here. You see this person here. I know it's late in the game, or at least for, like, what's the time? I think it's definitely more than 67th minute. But you see these people here. There is no one to pressure the person who's playing the ball here. You see here. And then you see like how he takes his own time. So I'll clear all drawings. And you see, 8 people are already involved, okay, in this game. 8. You see this person's here, tactics, what he has done here. He's like, you don't even like tackle. That's outright just kicking the ball. I'm not criticizing him. I'm criticizing his technique, what has been taught to him. Personally, he would not have any fault. That is a school level problem that you are seeing there. School level problem. School level play. You know, like kicking the ball out. You don't do that here. You kick the ball out. You can kick it to Rose. It. Even the greatest managers do it. Under them, they do it. But you know here, right? If you kick it to him, there's equal chance of it being deflected and coming here, and him taking the ball and probably shooting it here. Nonetheless, you see here, this guy is coming here. Fine, not bad. This player here, sorry, I'll just do this, undo. This player here, I don't know that you can see. Okay, this player here is running through the middle. He's seeing him here. He's seeing this person here. These two people are jogging and coming back. He should be a little bit faster to cover here. This person should cover this player here. He should, at the least, you know, like turn his head and see this player here who is here. This person should see him. This defender here who is here. Okay, I'll just take a different color. How do I see red? Okay, this defender here should say this defender that there's a player between, just see. And he should call this person out and say there's a player running from behind you. Or this person should can come here. I mean, like lot there's a lot of things like that, and that can be more tactical, but this is like children's play, like in terms of what mistakes are happening, and you see what happens here. Okay. I mean, this was lucky enough that nothing happened. You see here, similar stuff. How there's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and bear in mind this is a, you know, like a goal kick from when they are attacking, and you see like this is filled with Nepalese players. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 also will be here. Okay, and you see they will still get the ball through and dominate. Just look at this. I'm not criticizing this person here. Okay, you just see here. Okay. Technique decent, not bad. What is supposed to be done, he did it. But his positioning was wrong. You see again. If you get to see again, see here. He's running backward. He should turn around and run here for this person. And undo. Okay. They have so easily, changed, crossed, switch sides. You don't even realize. See, this person here is clearly outside the offside trap. So he's clearly playing someone in online. You see the line is here. Okay. If this is a three defenders plus one, four. This is the fourth defender. And he is clearly playing these people on, offside they would have wanted to, play. This is not happening because this guy has run in and the offside clearly is gone to a waste, the offside line, what if they would have thought about. If you see, I think you see this person here. If he would have been a little bit up, if you take I'll clear all drawings. If you see, okay, this person, if you would be in line with this, okay, if you would be in this line, what would happen is, first of all, this person here would be offside. I know we can't see him now, but that person would be offside. Secondly, this guy would not get the chance to run from here. And now he can do that. Why? Because he's clearly extending the offside line very high. So if he runs here, this defender will run in from here. This player will run in here. So that will drag this defender here, which in turn will let, there'll be a huge gap here between the two midfielders who can play between the line and dictate play. And also if this guy runs in here and this guy runs in here, this Ryan Grant from here will come here. And that will create a 2v1 situation. I don't think so that happened here, but that was all the possible things that could happen and probably they could have taken advantage of, but I don't know if that happened or we'll have to see. So yeah, so he cleared it out. So luckily for him, it was it was nothing else happened. So yeah, so I think I will stop the share there and go back. Okay, let me see. Okay, so yeah, Sushil, so that was analysis, as to say. So yeah, so as we are talking, the game has ended. And so Sushil, if you have any question like that, you can please say me. I will definitely I would entertain and I would answer your questions more than happily. I would generally answer all your questions in terms of tactics. Also, whatever to my knowledge, I would answer. And that is for sure. So we'll move ahead and we will see what has happened. So let me just check. Yeah, so it's a 2-2. Yeah, 2-2. This has, as you can see, the game has ended 2-2 from GMC Stadium. And Idrisiasia has scored the equalizer. And Nottingham United go on top of the table with that result. So we will go to UCL. That is UEFA Champions League. So I'm just trying to fix out where is my Chrome. So I've prepared what to speak. I don't want to go off topic. So in UCL, last night was eventful to say the least. Marseille, Porto won by 2-0. And Marco Grujic received the red card. The Liverpool player was on loan. So Zaidu Sanusi opened the scoring the 39th minute before Sergio Oliveira pulled one back. Doubled the scoreline via penalty in the 72nd minute. There was a red card each for both the teams. Marco Grujic received the red for Porto and Leonardo Balerdi received the red for Marseille. So that means Marseille almost virtually they can't qualify for any tournament because they can in third place. They are in fourth with 0 points, and after they have lost all the four games. And Porto are second with 9 points, and they have virtually almost qualified. Man City top the group with 12 points, and Olympiacos are third with 3 points after having lost the yesterday's game against Manchester City by one goal, which was scored by Phil Foden. So in the next group, Liverpool versus Atalanta, that was group D. It was from Anfield, and Liverpool lost 2-0. Jose Pulisic scored in the 68th minute before Robin Gosens doubled the scoreline and put the game to bed in the 64th minute. So Liverpool had 4 shots in comparison to Atlanta's 8, with Liverpool having 0 on target and Atlanta at 4. So it's quite a shocking result, but I mean, like, that's Champions League. Atlanta are a good team. And in the other game, Ajax won by 3-1 against Midtjylland, and that means Liverpool topped the group and are still on top with 9 points, having won 3 of the 4 games and lost 1. Ajax are second with 7 points, and Atlanta also are in third with 7 points, and it's going to be a more tough group. I think a win would guarantee Liverpool's qualification, and anything else would make it more difficult for Liverpool. I mean, if they don't qualify from now, from this position, it will be a very, very bad state. So moving on, Inter Milan versus Real Madrid ended in a 2-0 victory for Madrid. It was feisty. There was a red card in the game. Group B was feisty as usual. I mean, that's what is expected when you have such a strong group. So Eden Hazard finally scored in the 7th minute when he converted from the penalty. And former Madrid man and Dortmund man, if you are there, Sushil, Ashraf Hakimi scored an own goal in the 59th minute before. You know, like, of course, in the 59th minute, he scored there's an own goal, but I think they were already dead when Arturo Vidal received a foolish red card. You know, like, the foul was, to say the least, it was a yellow card, and he received a red card from Anthony Taylor for arguing. And that means, you know, like, Inter Milan are virtually, like, out of Champions League, basically. I don't see they can qualify, especially with Mönchengladbach having smashed Shakhtar Donetsk by 4-0. And that was the first game of the Group B yesterday. And last in, Stindl opened the scoring in the 17th minute when he converted from the penalty before Nico Elvedi's doubled the scoreline in the 34th minute. And Brie Lembelo, I mean, he's an amazing player, scored in the 45th plus 1 minute of injury time. And Oscar Wendt added the fourth in the 77th minute. So the win for Mönchengladbach and for Real Madrid puts the group in a very interesting position, at least in terms of the top three. I think Inter Milan are virtually out. So Mönchengladbach are first with 8 points. Real Madrid are second with 7 points. And Shakhtar are third with 4 points. So the next two games will be very, very interesting. You can even see Real Madrid dropping out completely. That would be a shock, you know, like, if Shakhtar win the next two games. And that will put them in 10 points. And if Real Madrid lose one and draw one, and probably if Shakhtar win both the games, which one of them is against Real Madrid, then Madrid out, because Madrid will have an inferior head-to-head with Shakhtar. So, yeah, that would be interesting, no? If out of this group, if Mönchengladbach and Shakhtar qualify, and Real Madrid and Inter Milan are knocked out. Very, very, very interesting that would be. So we'll move on to the final group, that is Bayern's group. So Bayern versus Salzburg. It was a 3-1 win for Bayern, routine win, not even something in deadly. It is routine. Even though they had a red card in their ranks, like Lewandowski opened the scoring in the 42nd minute before Kingsley Coman, who scored the winner against Paris Saint-Germain in last year's final. He doubled the scoreline in the 52nd minute. So Mark Roca received the red card in the 66th minute, but Leroy Sané added the third for Bayern in the 68th minute. And there was a consolation for RB Salzburg when Mergim Berisha pulled one back in the 73rd minute. And Lokomotiv and Atletico Madrid played out a 0-0 draw. So that means this group, I think, it's kind of plain sailing. Like, Bayern have qualified, perfect record, 4 wins from 4 games, goals scored 14 against 4, goal difference 11, points 12. Atletico Madrid are second, with played 4, won 1, drawn 2, lost 1. They have 5 points, and Lokomotiv are third, having drawn 3 games and lost 1 game. So I think if Madrid, Atletico Madrid win 1, I think they should qualify for the next round. Although it might be a little bit more scary because of the... this, and this is the result that you showed just before, but what is the main reason for that result? Okay, Sushil, so what is the main result for that result? There are multiple reasons that can happen. I can't say you like pinpoint one result. Like, I'll say you like some simple fact also, you know, like I'm covering something like Champions League, but I don't cover the Naples League, to say the least. So there is no interest, you know, like in the Naples football as of now. No one likes to watch. I mean, they like to watch, but, you know, like, people need to get more interested in the local games. And if I ask you, Sushil, who's the captain of Nepal? Would you know that? Who was the captain in the last 2 games against Bangladesh? You wouldn't know that. Nor would I know that if I was not involved closely. But, you know, like, those are like some small problems, like, okay, that, you know, like, we all have... Okay, we all have to play a part in, you know, like to increase the, you know, like, fan following of the game, and probably that will bring in more sponsorship. I can understand the point from sponsors also, like, they are not sponsoring because there is not much interest from the public. So why would they waste their money, you know? That makes sense, right? Does it? Yeah, I think it makes sense. I think from my end, at least, it makes sense. So, yeah. So, those are the major stuff that has happened over football in the past 12 or 24 hours. You know, like, we would have covered everything. Yeah, one of the sad thing that happened was legendary, one of the greatest players of all time, Diego Maradona, has passed away because of cardiac arrest, and that is quite sad to hear. And but I don't have anything to say. Like, you already hear so many people saying so many good things, and I personally didn't have any affiliation. Imagine, like, I didn't speak to him, but yeah, he did bring joy to many of them all over the world, and it is very sad to see someone so influential in not only his country, like, all over the world, being like passing away. Just very sad, you know, and untimely that, actually. I mean, like, it's not shocking, like, he passed away because of the lifestyle that he has had, but it's sad, you know, like, he has been in and out of hospital for since, I think, November beginning. He had few visits, and he also had a surgery, if I'm not wrong, you know, like, in, I think, around 12th or early November, and he was, I think, released from hospital on 12th, and on 25th he passed away. So he's been battling some injuries, and for his own injuries, being like multiple, when I say injuries, not like only muscle or bone, it's like maybe some organ problem or whatever problem. I really don't know much about that, but yeah. So there was like him visiting hospitals and being released continuously there, and I think it's very sad to see that. And Sushil, so if you have any question, do let me know. Other than that, I don't know. Like, yeah, so some in UK, I think we discussed it, like, few fans are allowed. I think in the list of criteria, I think Liverpool and let me just see Wolfall, Liverpool, Chelsea, Tottenham, all fall in the criteria who can have 4,000 fans. And I think United can't have, City can't have. I'll just update you. So yeah, so the latest update from the UK government has seen cities of Liverpool, London placed in Tier 2. Meaning, what does that mean? Very important. That means Liverpool, Tottenham, Everton, Fulham, Crystal Palace and West Ham can all have supporters in attendance at the stadiums. So I think Chelsea also. I can be wrong, but I think Chelsea also. Manchester is placed in tier 3, that means the risk of the virus spreading is huge there, because maybe for whatever reason, like there are more cases or whatever, they have the criteria to put them in the tier 3, and they will not be given the green light to allow fans in. The same rule has also been applied in across other parts of UK, affecting Wolves, Newcastle, Leeds United, West Brom, Sheffield, Leicester and Burnley, who will also not be allowed to open the stadiums for supporters at this moment. So you can expect 4,000 fans at Anfield or any of the London side the next time they play in Premier League. Of the 10 top flight stadiums that fall under Tier 2 restrictions, a maximum of 2,000 fans or 50% of the capacity, whichever is lower, will be allowed to attend fixtures from December 2, when the national lockdown for UK ends. So it's a good sight, and moving forward, I think slowly they'll work their up to moving back to full capacity, and that will be a long time, till that happens. So I think that is it for today. I mean, I'll just read out the ISL, what has happened. 2-2 draw. Kerala, if anyone has joined right now, Kerala Blasters and Northeast United have played an entertaining 2-2 draw, with Kerala leading at the halftime by 2-0, with goals from Sergio Sidoncha and Gary Hooper. And Northeast United, making a kind of a famous comeback, like what Goa did against Bengaluru, when Kwesi Appiah scored in the 51st minute, and it looked like everything is going against them when Kwesi missed a penalty. I think the 68th minute or 61st, I think 61st to 66th minute. And then Idrisia, the former QPR player, he equalized coming off the bench in the 98th minute. So that was the action from GMC Stadium. And the result mean Northeast United at top of the table, at least till tomorrow, when ATK Mohunbagan and SC East Bengal play the famous derby. And we'll be doing a lot more lives, a bigger live. And we'll see you tomorrow. Then I'll hopefully have some guests tomorrow. Till then, take care, watch our other videos, take care, stay safe, and bye.